Yeah, students, let's start from the dialogue of Lavrov towards the end of the page 77. Oxen meadows are mine, Natalia Stefanovna, ours, Lavrov mine, ours, mine. You see, students, in this way, both Lavrov and Natalia were arguing over the possession of the land of Oxen Meadows. And during the crucial moment of their vocal fight over the possession of the land of Oxen Meadows, Chubukov enters. Chubukov, what's the matter? What are you shouting at? Here, just after the arrival or just after the entrance of Chubukov in the drawing room, Chubukov wanted to know why they were shouting at. Natalia Stefanovna then requested her father, Papa, please tell this gentleman who owns Green Meadows, we or he. Natalia Stefanovna then requested her father to tell them who owned the land, either Lomov or they. Chubukov, to Lomov, darling, the meadows are ours. And here Chubukov then supported his daughter, Natalia, by telling that they possessed the land. Lomov then, but please, Stefanich, how can they be yours? Don't be a reasonable man. My aunt's grandmother gave the meadows for the temporary and the free use of your grandfather's peasants. The peasants used the land for 40 years and got as accustomed to it as if it was their own. When it happened that, then Lomov wanted to make Stefan Stefanovich Chubukov understand how they owned the land. And he told him to be a man with man of reason. My aunt's grandmother gave the meadows for the temporary and free use of your grandfather's peasants. And then Lomov wanted to indicate that as his aunt's grandmother gave the land of Oxen Meadows to the land laborers of his grandfather, they did not possess the land. He possessed the land. Lomov possessed the land. And the peasants used the land for 40 years. As a result of using the land for 40 years in this way, they got accustomed to means used to or accepting as normal, used to, habituated, accustomed to means habituated, H-A-B-I-T-U-A-T-E-D, habituated, accustomed to or used to. They got used to, they got accustomed, they got habituated to claim the land as their own. Excuse my precious, you forget just this, that the peasants did not pay your grandmother and all that because the meadows were in dispute. And here then Chubukov told him that he forgot the matter, that the peasants, the land laborers of his grandfather, did not pay his grandmother anything. And because the meadows were in dispute. Dispute means the matter of debate. Because the meadows were the matter of debate. And so on. And now everybody knows that they are ours. It means that you have not seen the plan. And here Lomov was Lomov understood the matter from the argument of Chubukov in this way, and then Lomov then pointed out that he would prove to him that they were mine. And then Lomov wanted to say that he would prove evidence, he would show them evidence to show that the land was theirs. You won't prove it, my darling, I said. Chubukov then Dear one, why ill like that? Here, Lomov got excited on hearing such type of words of claim about the land of obscene widows from Chubukov. Chubukov then said that, asking him why he shouted in this way. You won't prove anything just by yelling. Yelling means shouting loudly. Shouting. S-H-O-U-T-I-N-G. Shouting. Yelling. Just by yelling. According to Chubukov, Lomov could not prove anything about the position of the land by just shouting. I don't want anything of yours and don't intend to give up what I have. I don't want anything that you possess and I don't intend to give up anything of mine. Why should I? And you know, my beloved, that if you propose to go on arguing about it, I would much sooner give up the meadows to the peasants than to you. Here, Chubukov became angry at the time of indicating the position of the land of Oxen Meadows, telling Lomov that he would not give the meadows to Lomov. Rather, he would give the meadows to the other people rather than him, if he argued in this way. Lomov then, I don't understand. How have you the right to give away somebody else's property? Then Lomov told him that he could not understand how they had the right to give away something else's property. You may take it that I know whether I have the right or not, because, young man, I am not used to being spoken to in that tone of voice, and so on. Used to being spoken means accustomed. A-C-C-U-S-T-O-M-E-D. Accustomed. I am not accustomed or I am not used to being spoken in that tone of voice, in that attitude expressed in his speech, and so on. Young man, I am twice your age and ask you to speak to me without agitating yourself and all that. Agitating means being angry, anxious and nervous. Here, as Chubukov was twice his age means Lomov was 35 years old young man and Chubukov was twice his age. I, young man, twice your age, and ask you to speak to me without agitating yourself and all that. Here, Chubukov wanted to limit or control Lomov by telling that he should control himself. No, you just think I am a fool and want to have me on. You call my land yours and then you want me to talk to you calmly and politely. And here Lomov became also so much agitated and angry, telling that they thought him either a fool or a stupid person. Want to have me on and call me my land. You call my land yours and then you want me to talk to you calmly and politely. And here, as they demanded the land or claimed the land as their own, and at the same time he also told him to behave or to talk to him calmly and politely. How is it possible? Good neighbors don't behave like that. Stepan Stepanich, you are not a neighbor, you are a grabber. Good neighbors don't behave like that. Good neighbors like him. Good neighbors like Chubukov don't. Good neighbors like Chubukov don't behave like that. Stepan Stepanich, you are not a neighbor, you are a grabber. Grabber means one who seizes others' land forcefully and illegally. What's that? What did you say? The two of them got astonished on hearing such type of words from him. Natalia Stefanovna then told, Papa, send the mowers out to the meadows at once. Mowers means those who cut or trim grass or cereal crops. Mowers. Those who cut grasses or cereal crops. Chubukov, what did you say, sir? Oxen meadows are ours, and I said give them up. Natalia Stefanovna then was obstinate on hearing such type of words from Lomov. Then she also argued by telling that she would not give them up, as oxen meadows were theirs. She should not give them up. She should not give them up. We will see. I will have the matter taken to court and then I will show you. Then Lomo tells that he will take the matter, he will have taken the matter to court. The matter of dispute over the possession of the land of oxen meadows. Chubukov then, to court. You can take it to court and all that. You can. I know you. You are just on the lookout for a chance to go to court and all that, you pettifogger. Pettifogger means a lawyer who deals with petty cases. Pettifogger. A lawyer who deals with petty cases. Here, pettifogger refers to Lomov. According to the description given by Chubukov, Lomov is a pettifogger, as he will take in the matter over the dispute of the possession of the land of oxen meadows to court. All your people were like that, all of them. Lomov, never mind about my people. The Lomovs have all been honorable people and not one has ever been tried of embezzlement. Embezzlement means cheating. Embezzlement means C-H-E-A-T-I-N-G, cheating. A stealing of money kept in one's custody or care. Stealing of money or cheating. A stealing of money kept or put in one's care or in one's custody. Embezzlement. You Lomovs have had the lunacy in your family, all of you. All. Your grandfather was a Dunkard. Dunkard. Lunacy. You Lomovs have had lunacy in your family. Lunacy means insanity. Madness. M-A-D-N-E-S-S. Madness. Or insanity. Insanity. In your family. All of you. Here Chubukov wanted to indicate that all the members of Lomov or all the members of the Lomov's family had the insanity in them. All. Then Natalia also supported her father. Your grandfather was a drunkard. Drunkard means alcoholic. 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 And your younger aunt, Nastasya Mihailovna, ran away with an architect. Architect means a person who designs buildings. Ran away with an architect and so on. Here, in this way, both Chubukov and Natalia and Lomov abused or used so many insulting words in order to abuse one another. And your mother was humpbacked. Humpbacked means persons with abnormal hump on the back. Humpbacked. Humpbacked. A person, any person maybe. Here, Lomov wanted to indicate that Chubukov's mother was humpbacked. Humpbacked means Chubukov's mother had the abnormal growth on the back. clutches at his heart. Clutches means grabs tightly. Clutches means grabs tightly. G-R-A-S-P-S. Grabs tightly. T-I-G-H-T-L-Y. Grabs tightly. Something pulling in my side. Clutches at his heart. Something pulling in my side. My head. Help. Water. Your father was a guzzling gambler. Guzzling means eating and drinking greedily and voraciously. Guzzling gambler here refers to drunkard person. Here, Chubukov wanted to say that Lomov's father was a drunkard. And there have not been many backbiters to equal your aunt. Natalia Stefanovna then wanted to abuse Lomov by telling that his aunt was the best. His aunt was the best in the locality without any comparison in respect of backbiting. My left foot has gone to sleep. Gone to sleep means become numb. Gone to sleep means become numb. Become numb. N-U-M-B. Numb means lacking the power to feel or react. My left foot has become numb. You are an intriguer. You are an intriguer. Intriguer means conspirator. One who conspires. Intriguer. I-N-S. Inspirator. P-I-R-A-T-O-R. Inspirator. Sorry. Conspirator. C-O-N-S-P-I-R-A-U-R. Conspirator. One who conspires. Conspirator. Intriguer. Oh, my heart. And its open secret that before the last exams you be, I can see stars. At that very moment, he got excited. So much excited. I can see stars. I can see flashes of light in front of my eyes. I can see stars means, here, this is the expression that denotes the flashes of light in front of his eyes. Lomov can see flashes of light in front of his eyes. Where's my hat? Natalia Stefanovna then. It's low, it's dishonest, it's mean, harmful. You are just a malicious. You are just a malicious. Malicious means harmful. You are just a malicious, double-faced intriguer. Intriguer means conspirator, one who conspires, one who intrigues, double-faced character. You are a person with dubious character. You are a person with dubious character. A person with dubious character. Double-faced integer. The integer with dubious character. Yes, here's my hat, my heart. Which way? Where's the door? Oh, I think I am dying. My foot squat. My foot has got quite numb. My foot, I don't feel any power to feel or react. Goes to the door. Lomov then goes to the door. Chubukov also follows him. Don't set foot in my house again. Then Chubukov got so much angry and told him not to set foot in his house again. Natalia Stefanovna. Take it to court. We will see. Lomov staggers out. Walks out unsteadily. Staggers out means walks out unsteadily. Walks out unsteadily. Unsteady. Lomov walks out of the house unsteady, in an unsteady manner. Chubukov then, just after the departure of Lomov from the house or from the drawing room of Chubukov, then Chubukov utters or abuses Lomov by using so many insulting words. Devil take him. Devil means evil spirit. Devil means evil spirit. E-V-I-L. Evil spirit. Evil spirit. Devil take him. Walks about in excitement. Walks about in the drawing room in excitement. Chubukov got also so much excited. What a rascal. Rascal means a mischievous and cheeky person. A mischievous. M-I-S-C-H-I-E-V-O-U-S. Mischievous and cheeky person. Rascal. What a rascal. What trust can one have in one's neighbors after that? One cannot have any trust in one's neighbors after such type of incident or after such type of event. Chubukov then. The villain. Here villain refers to wicked person. Wicked person. The scarecrow. Scarecrow. Scarecrow is the word which means the figure of a man set in the field or set up to frighten away birds. Figure of a man set in the field or set up in the field to frighten away birds. The villain, scarecrow, rascal, such type of offensive and insulting words are used in order to abuse Lomov. Just after the departure of Lomov from the house of Chubukov. The monster. Natalia also abused Lomov by telling such type of insulting and offensive word by telling that he was a monster. Monster means wicked, very cruel and wicked person. Monster, very cruel and wicked person. Very cruel. Very cruel and wicked person. First he takes our land and then he has the impudence to abuse us. Impudence means showing lack of respect to others. Showing lack of respect. Showing lack of respect to others. First, Lomov claims about the land and then he also abused them. He showed the lack of respect to them and that blind him. Yes, that turnip ghost has the confounded cheek. Confounded means confused. Cheek means gull, G-A-L-L. G-A-L-L, gull. Confounded. Means confused. C-O-N-F-U-S-E-D. Confused. Cheek. Cheek means girl. To make a proposal and so on. What? A proposal. Chubukov then wanted to tell that such type of turnip ghost has the right to come to their house to give a marriage proposal or to proposal to his daughter and so on. What? A proposal? Chubukov then also got astonished. Natalia heard such type of words of proposal from her father. What proposal? Natalia got astonished on hearing such type of word, proposal. What proposal? Then she wanted to know from her father what type of proposal or what the proposal was. Why? He came here so as to propose to you. Chubukov then informed Natalia that Lomov had come to their house in order to give a marriage proposal to her and for this reason he came to their house. Here, dear students, you know that Lomov came to their house with a purpose to marry or to give a marriage proposal to Chubukov's daughter Natalia. But here, till now, Chubukov did not expose or express the matter for what reason Lomov had come to their house. But now you will see that just during the conversation between Chubukov and Natalia, just after the departure of Lomov from their house, Natalia came to learn that Lomov had come to their house to give her a marriage proposal. To propose to me. Why? Why didn't you tell me so before? Then Natalia got so much upset and asked her father why he had not told her that he had come to their house with a marriage proposal for her. So he dresses up in evening clothes, the stuffed sausage, the wizened face shrimp. Chubukov then also did not control himself, so he abused such type, or he used such type of insulting words in order to abuse him also. So he dresses up in evening dresses. We are such type of style of dress. She's the stuffed sausage. Sausage means a tube of raw or minced or cooked meat. Tube of raw or minced cooked meat. The wizened face means wrinkled face. Frump means unattractive person or an unattractive woman wearing old-fashioned dress. The wizened face, frump, stuffed sausage, such type of bad words or insulting words are used in order to refer to Lomov. But Natalia Stepanovna got so much upset on hearing such type of words of proposal from her own father, Chubukov. To propose to me, falls into an easy chair and wails, weeps, laments, bring him back here. Students, underline the sentence. Bring him back here. Here, this is the speech used by Natalia Stepanovna just after learning that Lomov had come to their house with a marriage proposal for her. To propose to me, falls into an easy chair and wails and laments. At that time, she earnestly requests her father to bring Lomov back again and again. This is the line, bring him back here. This is the line that is to be underlined. And here, from this line, question may be set. Who is the speaker? When does the speaker say this? What is the attitude of the speaker expressed in this speech? Here, just after the departure of Lomov, when Natalia came to learn from her father that Lomov had come to their house with a marriage proposal for her, Natalia said this. Natalia was the speaker, so. And here, the person whom they abused so many insulting words or whom they abused so many insulting words has now become so important person to him. So, such type of attitude of the speaker is expressed here. Now, the person whom she abused a while before has now become so important to him. Bring him, bring home here. Chubukov then wanted to now from his daughter, whom he should bring. Quick, quick, I am ill, fetch him. Hysterics means frenzy, F-R-E-N-Z-Y. F-R-E-N-Z-Y, frenzy. F-R-E-N-Z-Y, frenzy. Quick, quick, frenzy. Quick, quick, I am ill, fetch him. Hysterics. Natalia got into the abnormal state of being frenzy. What's that? What's the matter with you? Clutches his head. Oof, unhappy man, what? Unhappy man that I am. I will shoot myself. I will hang myself. Then Chubukov expressed contempt upon himself. Natalia Stepanovna, I am dying. Fetch him at once. Don't kill. Chubukov. Don't shout. Runs out. Chubukov then runs out of the house. A pause. Natalia Stepanovna wails, weeps, lamenting. Natalia Stepanovna, what have they done to me? Fetch him back, fetch him back. What have they done to me? Here Natalia Stepanovna laments in this way, weeping. Chubukov runs in, enters running. Chubukov, he's coming and soon, devil take him, oof. Talk to him yourself. I don't want to settle the matter in this respect. Natalia Stepanovna then laments, weeping. Wails, fetch him. Then Chubukov shouts loudly. He's coming. I tell you, oof. What a burden, Lord, to be the father of a grown-up daughter. Grown-up means adult daughter. Burden means cause of hardship, worry and anxiety or grief. Burden means cause of grief, worry and hardship. Hardship. I will cut my throat. I will indeed. We cursed him, abused him, drove him out, and it's all you. Here Chubukov wanted to make his daughter responsible for all this matter that had already happened. They had cursed him, they had abused him, they had insulted him, they drove him out even from their house, and for which it was only Natalia who was responsible for all these matters, according to the description of Chubukov. Then Natalia Stepanovna, no, it was you for all these. Natalia wanted to make her father responsible for all that had happened. I tell you, it's not my fault. Lomov appears at the door. Now you talk to him yourself. Exit. Chubukov then leaves the drawing room or exits or departs, leaving them in the drawing room. Lomov appears at the door, enters. Lomov enters exhausted. Being exhausted, Lomov enters into the drawing room. Lomov, my heart's palpitating awfully. My boots have gone to sleep. There's something keeps pulling in my side. Here, Lomov got so much nervous and excited. And in this way, being excited and agitated, and at the same time, being exhausted or tired, he entered into the drawing room. Forgive us, Ivan Vasilievich. We were all a little heated. We all were little excited. I remember now, Oxen Meadows really are yours. Here, now see students. Natalia Stepanovna wanted to surrender herself in all this respect to Lomov. Here, now you know that. she had already come to know the matter, for what reason Lomov had come to their house from her father.